Okay, you can state your name.
Gower Horton. I'm a tribute artist, Michael Jackson tribute artist. I'm just here for justice for Michael, and I'm here to make sure that the truth comes out, and that's what we're here about. That's what it's all about.
And Ken, can you tell me about your outfit?
I have another outfit under this, so that's why I have a different color shirt. But I just was doing a Thriller, and I had bought these pants somewhere at a reasonable discount. Okay. And I got this outfit together just to show my tribute to Michael. I do dance like him, I do sing, and I do love to do the tribute, but it's just, today I'm being solemn, you know, just kind of coming here. And I did dance a little bit to pump people, the fans up, to keep the memorial, you know,
Yes.
The morale. And to pray, and that's what I'm here to do, to pray and ask the Lord to reveal what's going on, and ask the Lord Jesus to reveal what's going on with Tommy Mottola, Sony, and all that stuff. I believe that that he was murdered.
Do you believe there was
Conrad Murray was paid off because of the Sony catalog?
Do you believe in conspiracy?
And that's what it's all about. It's about that Sony catalog, and it's demonic is what it is. Because he helped a lot of children. I was one of those kids who went to the ranch in 94. I was 10 years old. I met Michael Jackson. I met him more than once since. I can tell you that story another time. But that place was nothing but love. The whole place, free arcades, free ice cream. I mean, rides, anything. All you do is walk through and have fun. And then I went to the back, and there was the back of the movie theater. There was a sick girl in the back of the movie theater where he had a whole medical department back there. And that was just so that they could watch a movie with us without having to be sick, without having to be tied up in the hospital. So
what would you say to those people who accuse Michael of being a child molester based on the media accusations the way it was presented?
Well, at this point, because as angry as I am right now, I would say they're idiots. Let me tell you why they're idiots. If you just look at the evidence, not what the media said, not what this person said, not what that person said, evidence that I was there. I saw that lady. The lady was a con artist, Janet. By the way, the young man in the first trial, Jordan Chandler, has already admitted openly that was all a conspiracy. That's why his father tried to kill him with a barbell. That's why I said, look at the evidence. His own father tried to kill him with a barbell, and then he committed suicide. So we've been following this. He got guilty after that didn't work, so he killed himself because he realized what he did to Michael Jackson. Trial, let me tell you, one of the evidences was she said, oh, the fences were too high for us to get out of Neverland. He kept us there. He had nothing but picket fences about this high. Second thing was she said to Mesro, I can't call out on the phone. And so Mesro says to her, oh, can't you dial 9? And then they tell you there's a number you can dial. She goes, yes, she admits that. And then I also saw, I was in the trial when Macaulay Culkin was there. And Macaulay Culkin was accosted by the racist Ku Klux Klan. They are Ku Klux Klan members, by the way, Thompson and these people. And they said to him, I know you fell asleep in his bed. And he goes, well, I fell asleep in arcade machines. He said, that's the type of place Neverland was. He says it's a free place. And so they said, well, you were in his bed, so how do you know he didn't do anything? He said, I think I would have known if he did something to me. And they kept asking him, well, you're asleep, how do you know? He said, I think I would have known. Like that. So they go, oh, they had nothing else to say. And all the evidence in the trial, when it came down to the evidence, there was nothing. But it was the media that came and taunted him and molested him. He was the victim of molestation. He was the one that was raped. He's the one that was raped over the coals. He's the one they treated like dirt for several years, even though he was one of the greatest entertainers, one of the greatest gifts we ever had, God gave us. And now, this man over here killed him, is out here on vacation, up here drinking whatever he's drinking, some iced tea, acting like everything's cool. And these people just keep postponing this. And they can't they just get it on and just give the truth. And let me tell you something else. Like I said, it's about Tommy Mottola. It's about Sony. It's about the blood that's on their hands. That's what it's about. Because they killed an innocent man because they wanted his catalog. They wanted his music that he hadn't released yet. And he talked about it on the Thriller Killer speech on YouTube. He said they've been trying to stop my album, Invincible. who says, I have all, but I'm gonna give him these songs, a few songs, I wrote 100 songs per album. So Michael said, and he said, and you know what? And I'm gonna just break away from them. I'm not gonna do music anymore. I'm gonna do movies. I'm gonna break away. I'm gonna have my own music. I'm gonna be with my kids. That's all he wanted. They stole that from him. They stole it from him. And I'm here to make sure justice comes around for Conrad Murray, for Tommy Mottola, for these people. And I'm praying, and I'm standing, and we're looking at you, Tommy Mottola. We're looking at you. So Michael called you the devil.
Can you state your name once more for the record?
My name is Goward Horton.
And do I have your permission, Goward, to post this on YouTube?
Yes, you do. And say, everybody say, Jesus is Lord. I love everybody.
Michael crossed all barriers.
I love
ethnic,
everybody.
Religion,
when I say
them
you're
all.
An idiot, it's not because I'm saying that I'm trying to demean anybody.
You're talking about ignorance.
But it's ignorance.
Yeah, that's what Michael
that's
called
what it.
That's
what it is.
Ignorance.
And Michael did accept Jesus as Lord. I know he's in heaven. I'm happy about that. He's moonwalking on the streets of gold.
Okay, thank you so much.
All right.
You can state your name.
Hi, my name is Carolyn Owens Horton.
And
I'm Goward's mom. And we went to Neverland together and met Michael. We met Michael more than once. And the last time we met him, Joe and Majestic took a small group of us into the house. And it was like one of the most beautiful things you ever want to see. And Michael was there with his kids. And Michael did have vitiligo. I saw it on his hands myself. He had makeup on, but it was very light, so I could see through the makeup on his hands, and I could see that he does have vitiligo. And someone said that maybe his son may have it as well, Prince Michael. So anyway, I just want to say that we love Michael. He was so sweet. He was such a giver. He gave to everyone, and every time people came there to Neverland, he paid for it out of his own pocket. And he brought people even from the inner city and stuff which people don't tell you about. He even helped older people. And people send a lot of people to college, the United Negro Fund, and all kinds of different places. He sent people to college. People around his neighborhood, he helped to send them to college and to help them to school. And even his animals were friendly when he went on to Neverland. It was like a Disneyland, except you didn't have to pay for anything. They had kiosks with popcorn and candy and as much as you wanted, you didn't have to pay for it. And then they had regular food like chicken and gravy and vegetables and stuff like that as well. And so it was just beautiful and it would be the birds would be flying and the music would, classical music would be going and so peaceful and beautiful, just like Michael. And Michael's not a deity, and he does not want people to think that. He's not still alive, but he is in heaven right now, looking down on us and praying. We know that God is letting him know what we're doing down here to bring forth his legacy in a positive way.
Is there something you would like to say to Michael's fans around the world?
I want to say God bless you and love you.
Thank you so much. And I have your permission to post this on YouTube.
Yes.
Okay, thank you so much.